Welcome to an Aging Life Care Moment. I'm here with Leonie Nowitz, who is a founding member of the Aging Life Care Association, formerly known as the National Association of Professional Geriatric Care Managers. Leonie, a warm welcome. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and about how you got this amazing organization started?
Well, my first job in social work was at a nursing home where I worked with older people and their families. And it was a very good nursing home in New York City, private and not for profit. And I really enjoyed the work. And most of the people, the residents, did really well with the activities, with the programs we had, wonderful social work department. But I did notice that a few of them over the first few years I was there did not do well. They crashed into the facility without preparation after perhaps an emergency, and their families were also in bad shape and they did not thrive. They died shortly afterwards. And I began to think about what was going on in the community, even though there were public agencies. I knew the case numbers were very high. So I spoke to a friend and colleague, and she later became my business partner. And we decided to develop therapeutic and educational workshops in the community for family members of older people. And we did these workshops at the Y's, at universities, community centers. And we were astounded at how much of a need there was by family members who were stuck and not knowing what resources there were, having difficulty in their family relationships, being pulled by many demands in their own families, and not knowing the resources that could be of help. And we found it very fulfilling, you know, after a series of workshops. They weren't one shot, they were several sessions, 4 to 8 sessions. We felt very good about providing the help that we and the a program to them. And after that, which was about a year and a half afterwards, I really began to think strongly about a private practice model. And at the time, my colleague decided to stay at the nursing home, and I thought of perhaps working part-time, which I did. And I realized when I spoke to Adele Elkind, who was a colleague, and we chatted from time to time, that she had the same idea that older people and their families would be much better served with a private model of caregiving. We wanted the opportunity for families to meet on a one-on-one basis, to do assessments, to get to understand what they needed, to share the resources with them, to have them either use us as a guide or do their own thinking, you know, about what hours of care they would need, and whether other physicians or financial or legal consultants were needed for their specific situation. We called it a one-stop shop. So in 1982, after the first article in the New York Times, private teams help care of elderly, that listed several professionals in the New York area, we thought that it would be a great idea to get together. And so we met at Adele's home, which became the central place that we always met, to discuss what we were doing, how we were doing it, what the downsides were, what the plus sides were. You need to know at this time, private practice in this area was not very well regarded, you know, accepting a fee for service where people were horrified by.
You were groundbreakers in that regard.
Groundbreakers.
Yes. Basically, you saw the value of a really holistic, community-focused approach for care management, and the movement was born with you guys. It's incredible to hear that story.
Yeah.
So you've been a member for how long now?
Well, we started meeting in the, I think around 83, 84, and then in 85. We were meeting a few years before we had that first national meeting. And the reason we decided on that was when there was a second article in the New York Times in January of 1984. and it's care for far off elderly relatives. So then it had the spin that there were people who lived at a distance who were using private practitioners or agencies to help them with the care of their relatives. So after that, we saw that there were members across the country, not a lot, but we thought we were it, except for Rona Bartlestone, who we knew about and who was in Florida. So the group decided we had to have a conference. And so we set up a conference for the next year in 1986. I think it was June, and over 100 people came. And
oh my word, that's amazing.
We were astounded. It was like, this is not a small thing. There are a lot of people interested in this work. So it was very exciting. And we set up committees to do things. I was on the PR committee, but also the program committee for the following year. And gradually after that meeting, which was only one day, we found interest in various parts of the country. In Boston, a group of people contacted us, and Adele went and gave them several sessions on how to form a group, and different groups met throughout the country.
That's thrilling. Now, what roles have you played throughout your years at the organization? What are the ones that you really remember give you a lot of gratitude? And
well, I actually loved all the roles I played. I was first president of the local group of national, at the time we were called private care managers. It was a thing about that. We were closed to professionals, to not-for-profit at the time. And after Adele's term, I moved into the position, and I think I was there 2 to 3 years, which was really, really interesting because there were a lot of ideas and things going around, and we were still focused on the national conference. And then I do want you to know that in 1986, our meeting in Philadelphia was the one in which, I'm sorry, can you delete this? This is really
no worries, keep going.
Okay, I'm sorry. The National Organization of Professional Geriatric Care Managers was actually founded in 1986 at the second meeting in Philadelphia. And at that time, Sarah Cohen, who was a prominent member of our group and who did an enormous amount of work in getting the media to publish us. So we were in the Wall Street Journal, the New York Times, and all kinds of magazines across the country. I was in Modern Maturity and in other publications. But she really spearheaded the media to really make note of us. The other areas I really enjoyed was being program organizer. I like to work on the program. And I think for the first several years, I was very active. I remember going to Philadelphia and staying with some of our colleagues and going to meet different people who we thought should be invited, lawyers and social workers. We had to disinvite one really wonderful, well-known person because we had another idea of a business person working in the field of elder care. And that was a successful meeting, really went off well. And so the meetings proceeded in that line. There was always an annual meeting of the national. And I was pretty active for several years as program developer.
And you're still the only a very active member of our New York chapter today. We are really blessed to have you. Can I ask you what changes that you've seen in the aging life care industry over time, what the big ones are that you've noticed and that you think are big milestones for the organization?
Well, the fact that our services have been modeled by the not-for-profit sectors in hospitals and all over the country is quite a statement of acknowledgement of what we have developed over these years. The fact that there are so many dedicated and passionate colleagues, both at the top of our administrative offices, as well as the committee chairs, the people working on the committee, and of course the board, which I was on for a couple of terms at the beginning of our organization.
And what would you say at this point, Leonie, to an interested member that would like to join the association? What would you say to them, your advice to them?
I would say that this is a very dynamic, very well-established organization that has really carved its niche in the aging network area. And we collaborate with other well-known organizations. And I think it's a wonderful organization to join, to network, to have colleagues, and professionally to learn and grow as I have throughout these years. I do want you to know that I have developed areas of specialty in my work with older people, and one was in family therapy, which I felt was critically important, dealing with issues of aging, family. And I found that it was very helpful in allowing me to guide family members in more positive interactions with each other. And I had the wonderful opportunity of colleagues being willing to and open to hearing presentations that I did both at national and at the local chapter. In addition, I also developed a spiritually oriented focus in assessing older people's values and needs, and really working to provide a meaningful life in the light of so many losses that so many of them have when we walk into the picture. So I did actually share my work with the organization. I developed a spiritual assessment tool, which I shared and offered to colleagues. And I felt it was a wonderful milieu in which I was heard and that people were responsive to me, and also published in Kathy Kress's A Handbook for Geriatric Care Management, which just, by the way, is in probably its fourth edition at this point. It's a really seminal book. What else would I recommend?
I think, Leonie, as we wind down, I just want to thank you for your service to the organization. The organization is celebrating its 35th year anniversary, and we have you to be thankful for as a founding member. So congratulations, and
thank you.
We have a great virtual conference, and thank you for being interviewed today.
Thank you, and I want you to know it wasn't me alone. It was being joined by partners such as Adele, other colleagues, Jerry Charnow, Lenise Dolan, who sadly has died, Sarah Cohen, who has died, and many others who are either with us or not. But it was really a collaboration of being open to each other and really wanting to move this organization forward. And I believe it still continues today. And I am absolutely thrilled as to where the organization is now. And I would say welcome to anybody who has the background and the interest to work as a care manager.
Thank you, Leonie. Take care. Thank you.